What's up, guys? In this video, you're going to learn how to set up Google Ads remarketing tag in Google Tag Manager, step by step. Let's do this. The first step is log into your Google Ads to get your remarketing tag conversion ID. If you notice that you don't have the same features as you're going through this tutorial, you could be in Google Ads Smart Campaign. So if you notice this, go to Tools, and there should be an option for you to click on Switch to Expert Mode. While we're in Tools and Settings, we need to go to Shared Library and then click on Audience Manager. Then over the left side tab, you want to click on Audience Sources. And even though I already have my remarketing tag installed, you can still follow the same process to install the tag. Over here, you will find a Google Ads tag. You want to click on these three dots and click Edit Source. There are three steps you need to go through to obtain your remarketing tag code. In remarketing, you want to check on only collect general website visit data to show ads to your website visitors. Now, if you collect data on specific actions performed for your website to show personalized ads, it will open up business type, which allows you to add parameters to collect activity specific to your type of business. Now, if you have any one of these business types, you can select it here. This shows tailored ads that contain your products and services, and you will need to create a feed that contains your products and services. For this tutorial, we just need to collect website visit data, so I'm selecting the first option. For restricted data processing, if your business falls under the California Consumer Privacy Act, which is similar to the EU GDPR for data privacy protection, then click on this. I'll leave this unticked and then click on Save and Continue. As we will be installing our remarketing tag via Google Tag Manager, I'm going to click Use Google Tag Manager, and you'll notice your conversion ID here. So you want to copy that and leave this page open. Now guys, if you haven't installed your Google Tag Manager container code on your website yet, you can click on Detailed Instructions and then I'll provide instructions on how to install your Google Tag Manager code. Okay, so now that we have our conversion ID, we're going to go to Google Tag Manager and click on New Tag. For all my Google Ads related tags, I have the following naming conventions. It could be Google Ad or G Ads for short. And then it's dash the type of tag it is and what pages or what actions am I triggering. So we'll leave it at Google Ads. This type of tag is a remarketing. And then we're triggering or pages. For the tag configuration, click on that. And then you want to select Google Ads remarketing. We need to go back to Google Ads and copy that conversion ID and then paste it in here. For custom parameters, I'm going to set it at none, but if you're an e-commerce store, you can go in and configure it for custom parameters using data layers. For triggering, select that and then you're going to select all pages, which means that the remarketing tag will fire on all pages on your website and send that data back to Google Ads. And just one thing to note, it's within the Google Ads interface. That's where you create your custom audience list for specific pages on your website. You don't create those audiences within Google Tag Manager. Okay, so let's double check this. You've got your Google Ads remarketing tag, the conversion ID, and it's firing on all pages on your website. We want to click Save. And now we're going to hit Submit. And under version name, just give it a description of what you just created. So we just added the Google Ads remarketing tag and then click on publish. Head back to workspace. Then we want to click on preview. Preview allows us to test that the tag is installed and firing on all pages correctly. Next, you want to go to your website or landing page and hit the refresh. So I'm going to refresh my landing page. And then Google Ads preview mode will be up. Now I'm looking for the Google Ads remarketing tag that we just created. So this is the Google Ads remarketing tag that we've just created. I've got two Google Ads remarketing tags because I've already installed it. Then I'll refresh the thank you page just to make sure that the remarketing tag is also tracking this page. And it's shown here. Okay, we're good to go. Now let's head back into Google Tag Manager. And then leave preview mode, press OK. Now I want to go back to my landing page or your website in your case, and then check the Google Tag Assistant, enable it, refresh that landing page or your website, and I'll click on it and I can see that there's two remarketing tags installed since we created a second one. Okay, and that completes the Google Ads remarketing tag installation via Google Tag Manager. If you followed along with my video on how to create a Google Ads campaign step by step, where I created a landing page and a thank you page, I can now go back into Google Ads and create a remarketing list for anyone who visited the landing page but did not land on the thank you page. And by the way, guys, this is just a mock landing page. Don't enter in your email because I don't have a free meal plan. Now we're going to head back to Tools and Settings, go to Shared Library, and then click on Audience Manager here. And we're on the audience list. Click on this plus icon and click Website Visitors. I'll name this audience Free Meal Plan Remarketing 14 Days, and I'll explain why later on I put 14 days. List members would be visitors of a page who did not visit another page. Under Visited Page, the page URL contains Free Meal Plan because that's the landing page, and the unvisited page, which is the page they did not visit, that's the thank you page. And that URL would contain MPTYP. Under pre-fill options, pre-fill lists with people from the past 30 days. I'm just going to leave it as is because we don't have any data on it. Under member duration, this is the amount of time someone will stay on your remarketing list based on visiting the landing page but not visiting the thank you page. So I'm going to set it to 14 days. So this should be similar to your average buying or conversion cycle. Let's say you're selling tickets to an event and it ends in a few days. You might set that membership duration to 5 days only. But if this is a high ticket item like cars, that's a longer conversion period and I might set that to 6 months instead. Now in this tutorial, it's a free meal plan. I'm going to set it to 14 days because I don't want to keep showing my ads to people if they haven't opted in within 14 days. Okay, and let's give this a description. I'll just write down visited landing page, but not thank you page. Click on create audience and we're done. Okay guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Until next time, see ya.